It all comes down to this. It is game one of the Calder Cup playoffs for the LGAHLPSN League. Game one tonight. Rockford and Hartford about to get underway. Hi, everyone. T-Sibs with you, along with Miranda Conda and V-High. We are here as usual, and we are live for tonight's game. Guys are starting to gather up right now in the dressing room, getting ready for their game one. Quickly, V-High, what are you looking for in this game, first game of the series?
Rhino and Blues and Gilly can get something going up front for Rockford against this very solid Wolfpack defense. Mike?
Moran?
Well, I'm looking to see what exactly is going to happen here on the Hartford side as far as, their defensive play, see how they're going to be playing the team game that they play. They are going against the leading scorer in the AHL this season, in Rhino, along with his brother, Let's Go Blues, playing center. So, it's going to be a hotly contested game here. I expect a lot of scoring opportunities. Now, whether or not those turn into goals or not is another thing to be said here. And, I think we're going to store for a high-paced, quick, offensive game here, and we'll see who can shut it down defensively.
Right now, they're still gathering in the locker room. Looks like Greeno is they're waiting for their goaltender right now, and on the I guess that would be the Hartford side. They're back in again. They're still waiting for their goaltender to show up, and as you may have seen already on the website, starting lineups at this point for both teams right now. For Rockford, since we can see them all there and confirm it, although it looks like we have a change at right wing because Camagraph was supposed to be the starter, but Fat Jilly is in there now. We still have Let's Go Blues at center and Rhino on the left, D Peasy and Jay Nasty on defense, and Rask in goal. And so that must have been a late change because that was Camagraph earlier today. So certainly scheduling issues, I guess, at this point.
Yeah. Sounds like it might be, or looks like it might be. Still a really good lineup out there. That's a dangerous lineup to start the series with for sure. 104, 63, 87, those are the point totals for the three forwards for Rockford. What's the Hartford starting lineup, Sibs?
Well, we see Wally 919 in there at center, and Tommy LeGamer at right wing, and the blind ref is on right wing. I'm sorry, instead of Tommy, and Wally is still on the center. Actually, no. So they really screwed this up. Now we have Wally as the center, Tommy LeGamer as the left winger, blind ref is right winger. Weed Farmer and Greeno are still the defensemen. And so Durst, for whatever reason, is not playing tonight. And I'm not sure what that reason would be.
Yeah, and we'll find out what's going on in net with Hartford whenever their goalie does show up here. So it'll be an interesting matchup tonight between these two lines. Hartford going out with a very solid lineup here. And, of course, they're quite possibly their top defensive pairing against this top scoring left winger for the Rockford IceHogs. How are we feeling heading into the game, Mike?
Well, it does look as though Jonesy is going to make it into this game. There was kind of some questions there. His internet was giving him some issues, but it looks like he is currently restarting and he's getting ready to go here, getting ready to join his teammates in the dressing room there. So it is going to does look like it is going to be Jones going for the Hartford Wolfpack.
Still waiting for him to show up, though. So hopefully we will get this game underway soon. But as we've talked about yesterday in the show, we have we have two teams that I think we all thought would probably be there in the end. And Hartford with their management mostly pretty much intact, right guys? I think from season one, came back and put this team together again to get right back to the championship, and that speaks volumes for their for their ability to put talent on a squad.
It is a different management group in Hartford, but Beefy did kind of assist with the management of that team last year, and I believe he kind of took on an AGM role towards the end of the season. So they've just got a great team over there. Beefy's done a great job gathering talent this season. A lot of them are on what looks to be one-year deals, so a lot of those guys could be making their way up to the NHL come the end of the season because a lot of them were prospects as well before the season started. So a lot of those guys could be seeing their way up into the NHL lineups very soon, as soon as season three coming up in September or October here.
Yeah, and I do want to point real quick towards the thread box on the LGAHLPSN homepage. Jay Claus did post a story about this final series between Hartford and Rockford, and he's got interviews from Shiz Nasty and Blade Runner GT on there. Give that a read real quick. It's got a pretty good breakdown and some really good insight on both of these teams. And, I thought Claus did a really good job of putting this thing together. And he ragged on himself just a little bit in there, too. So give that a look and see what you think. I think it'll get you into this series and get you ready to go to see who's going to win this thing.
Still waiting for Jones to show up in the locker room at this point. And so hopefully we get this game underway very soon. I know for Claus, it's bittersweet that he's glad that his guys are there in the championship game here. But, the bottom line is that he wishes that he was there to play this. This is what he built them for. This is what he was, working hard before the season to put together this club. And unfortunately, he's not going to be there to play it. But he's been there for support, and he has also been pretty good support and good on the social end with the site, despite the fact that he was suspended for the rest of the season. So good to see somebody like that who's a hell of a player still remain involved with it and not crap talk the league or anything else. He took his medicine, and he is now still, if his team can win, I don't know if it's vindication or not, but it's certainly it's going to feel a little bit better for him to know that he put together a winning team. And so this will be interesting to see how it plays out and whether or not these guys can complete the tasks that they have been, on the whole year and really aiming towards it. And I think everybody pretty much expected them to be there. Maybe we had a lot of teams that were hoping that they get beaten somewhere along the way. And, again, we talked about this yesterday, a couple of 2-0 scares first two rounds, but this team is just incredibly powerful, and they always find a way to come back.
Yeah, they've found a way. I think they're just kind of starting to hit their stride here under the leadership of Kraz and Chiz. They're starting to find their legs. They've put together a great series against the Condors. They basically dominated that series and kind of just, walked their way into the finals here, which is what everybody expected them to do through the playoffs. But they had a tough time in the first two series, but then they came as advertised in the conference finals and basically just stuck it to the Condors to get themselves into the finals against the Wolfpack. Now, the Wolfpack, I think, is, it was either going to be one of two teams, according to a lot of people this season. It was going to be the Amerks, which is the Americans, or the Wolfpack. And the Wolfpack, basically went out and took offense to the fact that people would think that the Americans were going to push them over this season and just give them a spot into the finals. And the Wolfpack really put up their dukes, and they battled their way, walking through the first two, winning them 4-0 and 4-0, and then having just a little minor slip up against Rochester, dropping two games to them. But in the end, they found themselves in the finals as well. So this is going to be, two teams that took similar paths, but a little bit different paths through the playoffs, and I think they're going to be primed and ready to go once this game gets underway here.
I really think they are. you know, if you read that story, go ahead.
No, I think we're still waiting here. So, again, still waiting for Jonas to show up in the room or anybody else. I haven't seen any notification that there is any change other than from what Mike said. So I think at this point we're still waiting as we look at the locker room right now as they get ready to match up here. And this, you know, we talk about all the logistics of the game and what – NHL and the software can do, and there's all sorts of obviously there's all sorts of thoughts and ideas about what happens if you're sitting in a room too long, and does that affect how the gameplay is with 16? You know, let's I'll throw it out to you first, Mike. With 16, do we still feel, even with the updates, that sitting in a room like this for too long is detrimental to your connection?
Well, you know, it's all hearsay, I think. It's all, you know, stand on one foot, wrap tinfoil around your head, and, you know, pray to the gods of EA Sports that you don't lag in a game. I don't know. I think it's completely hearsay. I've never really heard anything that proves it. I have noticed that maybe it does cause it, but I've played plenty of games where we sat in rooms and it was fine going into the game. So, you know, like I said, I think it's a lot of hearsay. But, you know, just be on – To stay on the side of caution, if it were me, I would message everybody and say, hey, let's reset this room. This is the finals. We don't know. We don't want any BS coming in the way between us and a victory tonight.
Yep. And sorry about stopping before. I accidentally pulled up the YouTube link and Mike started talking in my ear.
It's bad enough when it's once, having to hear it another time is.
Yeah, that's what I was like, wait a second. Didn't you just get done saying that? And it's because it pulled up the live stream and it's only like 30 seconds behind. That's funny. But anyway, yeah, what I was saying was in the story that Jay Claus posted, there's some quotes in there from Beefy and kind of funny, because I think that I think the point of putting those out there was to try and get some fire between these two teams for the final, because it's kind of been a series that we would have loved to see all season long. But basically Beefy said he if they get past Rochester, he'll overlook the IceHogs. The Calder Cup is theirs. And so the IceHogs obviously want to prove them wrong.
Well, it looks like Rask is volunteering to maybe play golf with him. So we'll see whenever Jones shows up how this all works out. Boy, this has got to be frustrating for Chiz and for the rest of the team. You know, you get to the finals, you get to the first game, and your goaltender is having connection issues, whatever the case may be. And you have to worry about this now. And this has to be making Chiz a little bit nuts at this point, being beating the interim GM of this team. I got to believe Mike would be about ready to jump off a bridge and Jonathan right behind him. This cannot be easy to have this happen to you, right, guys, I would think.
No, I would be absolutely beside myself. And, you know, there would definitely be things being coming down the line. You know, I'm not at liberty to talk about things that are going on currently, but, you know, there would definitely be some extreme anger on my part. And, you know, some things just can't be stood for. You know, and we just hope that Jonesy can make his way through that tunnel and get down to the locker room with his teammates that he's fought with all season to get to this point and play in these finals. You know, I really hope that everything's all right with them, and I hope Jonesy can make it. And, you know, we'll see what happens here in just a few minutes.
Yeah, we're on live, and I, you know, love getting live updates and everything, but I do not like the idea of getting some breaking news at some point. We need this to happen. We've been waiting for it. We need to get this going.
The question is, do they, you know, at this point, are they going to all back out? I see Nasty's in the room with them. So I'm sorry. That's Jay Nasty. So, I thought I had seen someone back out completely, but I think we have everybody again except for Jones at this point. But yeah, this has got to be incredibly frustrating, and you know, you want to get these games going. You've been waiting for them to come up, and now there's a delay. And I know in some parts, well, you know, obviously it all depends on where you live, but I know on the East Coast we're having some storm issues. So I'd have to look up Jones and find out, see if he even told you where he's from. But you know, it's incredibly frustrating to have to wait and wait. And then if he's having an issue, you know, these guys are just sitting there, probably could get some practice in if they had the time, but now they just have to wait. And it's obviously not the same as playing the real game of hockey, but at some point you have to get a little bit cold.
Yeah. Jones does say he is having internet issues in the shout box here. You know, it is internet issues, you know, and that sucks. That really sucks, you know, when there's nothing that you can do about it. And, you know, it just sucks, you know. So obviously, I mean, what are you going to do? We're trying to get it figured out here. Beefy and Chez are in conversations here, and we're trying to get this game going here as soon as we can.
Says he's joining now, so
joining now, so we shall see what goes on here. Hopefully, it's not a. We're just gonna cross our fingers on a smooth, clean game here.
I think I'm assuming they're restarting the room.
Yeah, they're gonna restart the room, which is probably. I mean, just in case, it's probably a good idea.
I think it's a great idea. Honestly, like I said, I think it's. You know, who knows if it actually is. You know, if it does affect it or not, but why take a chance when you can just reset it? Get everybody in there fresh, start from scratch, and get the ball rolling.
Right, exactly.
Well, and at this point, there's only, you know, guaranteed maximum of 7 games left this season. So if you're going to start off a 7-game series for the finals, for both sides' sake, you probably ought to make sure you get it done and do everything you can to make sure it doesn't have any chance for that situation to cause a lag. Hopefully, we're getting ready to go.
Yeah, hopefully so.
Still nothing yet to show you. They are restarting the room, so hopefully we'll get back to that shortly. And the changes in the lineup, and again, you have to wonder what some of the reasoning might be. You would like to believe that you have reliability and these guys, you know, when they say they're ready to go yesterday, they're ready to go a day later, that's the case. Wondering if there is a bigger connection issue, a weather issue that is, you know, causing some problems for a couple of these guys. But, you know, hopefully we'll get some answers a little bit later on tonight or at least tomorrow. And we can talk about it when the time comes. But at this point, I think they're starting to regather in the room now. Yep, that's pretty much what they're doing. It looks like the Hartford team is getting back into the room now and getting set. So we will endeavor to see how that works.
Yep. And I see that... See that all of the Ice Hogs are in there now, so hopefully we can get all the Wolfpack in there and get 12 guys and maybe get this plane off the ground.
Yep. See what we got going on here. Interesting way to start game one of the Calder Cup Finals here. You know, in a perfect world, this game would have gotten off right at 8:30, but here we are, 10 minutes to... 9 or 10 minutes to 11 on the East Coast, and you know, hopefully things are looking up here. We shall see. We are still missing one, so hopefully he and there he is. All right, we have a game, gentlemen.
And so now you're looking live into the matchup room, and hopefully we will get this game underway in a matter of a minute or so. We are, let's see, they've got blues, so they've got the rest of their lineup, so hopefully they're They're getting all lined up there and there. Blues is about ready to get in as well. So I think we're finally going to get this game underway. A good, I don't know, 20 minutes past the actual start time. But, you know, better late than never.
We were on time.
Well, again, this is a matchup I think we were expecting, and it's one that is going to be incredibly interesting to see. And face-off will take place here in a moment. Again, just to recap, we've got Tommy LeGamer now on left wing, Wally 9-19 at center, the blind ref at right wing for Hartford. Lefty is Greeno, right D, Weed Farmer, and the goalie is Jones for Rockford. Rhino on left, Let's Go Blues, the center on the right is Fat Gilly, and lefty DPZ, Jay Nasty at right D, and the goalie is Rask.
This is going to be a battle here. I think that's the key to this game is going to be how well the Wolfpack can play their defensive style and shut down the offensive juggernaut that is the Rockford IceHogs. And, you know, these guys are going to go head-to-head here, and it's going to be a battle of the offense versus the team play. And we're going to see where this one's going to lead to us here in just a few moments as they get ready to drop the puck on game one of the Calder Cup Finals in season two of LGAHL.
Hartford gets initial possession, and right up the middle on a break. And it looks like the puck came off his stick a little bit for Wally. Now back the other way comes Rockford. Some trouble now. Wally picks up in his zone and heads into the Rockford zone, dumps in and behind the net. Some play there, and Rockford comes out with it. Looks a little tentative early on here. No score, 17 minutes left to go, and Rockford now heading back into their zone. It looks a little bit, guys, like that pressure they talked about is working for Hartford.
Yeah, it looks like they're playing a nice 2-3. They're forechecking hard. They're throwing two forwards in deep and keeping the center up high. And it's just got Rockford rattled right now. And, you know, it's kind of turning into a neutral zone battle. I think nerves are getting the best of them currently. But we'll see if both teams can't settle in here as the Hartford forecheck is just relentless.
Gilly looks to be getting to the net for a shot. And the puck down went behind the net. Hartford still maintains possession. And that's Gilly on the right side. Still fighting for the puck in the corner. Still has possession. Looking for back to the point. He's got his man. Now point pass is broken up and taken back the other way by Rockford. And they look to set up their offense. But again, Hartford defense breaking things up. Now behind the net, Let's Go Blues trying to get something going. Pass out front is blocked to the point. Shot on goal and a save there by Jones.
I think Hartford's doing a great job defensively and on the forecheck right now. They're really pressuring Rockford well. They're keeping them to the outside here. They're pressuring them, forcing them to make plays with the puck in their own defensive zone. And it's been tough for Rockford to get up the ice so far. And, you know, Hartford looks like they're really feeling it tonight. And Rockford looks a little shaky. We'll see how this one goes here.
10:26 left to go in the first period. No score. As you can see, we get back to the action here. And off the faceoff, Hartford gets possession, looks to work it out.
I love the patience by Hartford here getting out of the zone.
Now Rockford breaks it up. Blues with the puck, trying to maneuver around. Gets stolen again by Blues, and now it'll come out for Hartford as they work it out. Wally gets it to the middle. Shot from Gilly is blocked. And now back into the Hartford zone as they try and play it again.
Well, Hartford's doing a really good job of controlling the puck so far halfway through the first period. This is pretty dominant puck possession by them so far. Each time they lose it, they're getting it back.
trying to get it out to the point for Peasy, but that's broken up. And now Rockford comes back the other way. But Hartford is there, clogging up the middle. Now back out front, and a shot save by Jones, and he'll cover it up.
That was a nice little give and go there. I fed it down into the corner, broke to the high slot, got the puck right back, and was able to get a very, very high scoring opportunity chance there from the high slot. That was a great play by Rockford.
Face off to the left of Jones, and Hartford wins it. We're approaching the 5-minute mark in the first period. Still no score. And now Hartford dumps it in. Wally gets it deep. Rockford has it, moves it out. Now Rhino trying to work something in there. Shot on goal is a save. Now back out front, and another save by Jones, and he'll cover up.
Boy, it really looks like Jones is feeling it tonight. He's made some great saves here in the first period to keep his team tied at zero here.
Face-off puck possession now for Rockford. And a nice play by Blues, but he could not hold on to the puck. And Hartford looking to work it out. Puck loose in front. Another save by Jones. And now Hartford will work it out.
Well, Jones is doing his job when he's getting the chance here. He hasn't seen a lot of time in his own end, but he's come up with some really big saves as Hartford comes really close to a goal right there themselves.
Good opportunity there, but a miss. And so Hartford's still trying to keep it deep in the zone. Holding on to it, still working it.
That's a relentless forecheck.
And that's what they talked about yesterday. Looks like we're going to get our first penalty now on Hartford. And Rockford looking to maybe work it down and get something going. But the period has ended, and they will start the second period with a power play. But after one period of play, we have no score in game one here of the Calder Cup Championship. And I tell you what, again, we talked about this a little bit. Looks kind of tentative right away.
It does. It looks very tentative. You know, it doesn't seem like Rockford has quite hit their stride yet, but that's due to the Wolfpack really throwing a couple of forwards in there deep, keeping them in there, keeping pressure on the puck, and they're really making life miserable for Rockford in their own end right now. And, you know, Rockford's just been having a tough time getting out of their zone cleanly as the Wolfpack have just been in the passing lanes. They've been reading the plays very well. They're doing a heck of a job keeping Rockford off their game in this first period here.
They really are, but Rockford has done a good job of attacking when they've had the opportunity, and they're getting some good scoring chances at the net, so we'll look to see how that unfolds during this power play in the second period.
Well, we'll get to watch this one from the penalty box for a little while. As Hartford has possession of this, dumps it in, and Rockford will have to start out on this power play with a minute 30 left to go, but pass is broken up. And now they try to push it in again, get it into the Hartford zone, and now looking to set up. Puck kept in. Now a good pass is broken up, and Hartford will push it out. Good pass by Let's Go Blues, but it was broken up there on D, and 20 seconds left to go now for the Rockford power play. Getting deep in the zone, and again, broken up, and the penalty is now over. Teams are at full strength. And Hartford survives the first penalty kill. Now Hartford coming back.
And how many times?
With a long, long goal. I'm sorry, that was Greeno with a long shot from the point, and it is in, and Hartford with the early 1-0 lead.
And it looked as though he was just trying to get it to the net there and just, you know, get it in deep and see if they couldn't bang home a rebound. And it ended up going off the goalie's left pad and right into the net there. And it's 1-0 Hartford.
Great save there by Rask on a cross-crease pass. And he holds on for the faceoff. 15:27, as you see, left to go in the second period. Hartford with the early 1-0 lead.
And how often do you see that happen where they kill off the penalty there and then go right down the ice and score a goal? They've obviously built a little bit of momentum for themselves here, the Wolfpack have, after killing that penalty and getting the goal on the board.
Rockford trying to work it in. Pass out front is blocked. Shot is blocked. Rockford gets it back, but Jones is right there in front. Man, they are not getting any clean opportunities, are they, at this point?
Well, no, they are not.
I'll tell you what, Hartford is in every passing lane. They're really clogging up the middle well, and it seems like their sticks are constantly on the puck. You know, it's just a great job. You can tell they're well coached, and, you know, they're really sticking it to them here so far.
Wally trying to get something going here and gets it out in front, but partially tipped. And now, sorry, that was Blues. And now Hartford back the other way, but broken up nicely by Rockford. And again, trying to get it back into the Hartford zone. Blues tries to get a pass out to the point, but that one goes back into the Rockford end. So now they regroup. 11 minutes left to go in the second. Still 1-0 Hartford. And now Hartford working it out of their zone. Gilly flips one in. Oof. Just missed the net, but now Rockford working it out.
Might sense a little bit of nervousness on the Rockford goaltender after that first goal. He looked a little tentative on that one, going just a little bit wide.
Long wrist shot in on Jones, and the save is made, and he'll hold.
Well, the Wolfpack are doing a great job. Just, you know, they're playing as a team. You can tell they're really playing well as a team here and moving the puck great. And it seems they've got Rockford all out of sorts currently.
Another good opportunity there, but not able to connect. And now Rockford coming back the other way. And Hartford breaks that up. Throws it into the Rockford zone. And now there, IceHogs are working it out. That pass broken up. Still having trouble getting it out. Now, across the blue line of Hartford and in behind the net.
Puck see a little around. Bit of a change of strategy here by Rockford, getting the puck deep and trying to chase it down because Hartford's doing a good job of clogging the blue line in the neutral zone.
Good quick pass, and now Hartford trying to break out an opportunity, but the pass is broken up right at the net. And now Rockford trying again, under 4 minutes in the second left to go. 1-0 Hartford. Now a pass in front, and that first initial shot was blocked, but the rebound picked up and scored by Rhino. His first goal in this championship series. He ties it at one.
Well, persistence paid off there. They kept getting the puck to the net, looking to bang in those rebounds, and on the second try, the puck did drop right there in the crease, and they were able to scoop it up and put it into the back of the net.
So finally, a break for Rockford, and they're able to tie this one up. We're under 2 minutes now in the second period. And now, again, Hartford trying to get something going, but now there will be a Rockford penalty. Hartford looking to get their goalie off and get something going here with an extra man. Pass in front, shot, and oh! Nice save by Rask, keeping that one there off the doorstep. Now, tripping penalty gives them a power play. Hartford on the attack and blocking the pass out of the zone. And now Rockford coming back the other way, trying to get something going, at least killing the penalty. And so the second period now comes to an end. And another close period, and certainly a close game.
It was really interesting to see how the Wolfpack are able to get back off after giving up that goal there. Beautiful goal by Rhino to stay with it behind the net. They got the puck deep and moved the puck behind Jonesy a little bit and were able to stuff in a rebound. But the Wolfpack get their power play back here, and we'll see if coming into the third period, starting their second straight period on the power play, if they can make anything happen here or if Rockford can continue to chip away at their defensive strategy.
Face off, we start the third period with Hartford getting into the zone first. Still on the power play with 1:10 left to go there. Now behind that nice back pass and a good shot. But again, Rask up there for the task. Hartford bringing it back in. They've got some numbers. Shot. Wow. And that is a beautiful top shelf score. And again, Greeno with his second goal of the game has put Hartford ahead 2-1.
Well, Greeno just took that puck from the blue line there and just walked it right into the net and, you know, didn't have anybody to pass it to, decided to take the shot himself and ended up getting it to go top shelf there on Rask. It was a great shot by Greeno.
And a couple of good saves there as Jones continues to play a nice game. And Hartford and their defense looking to work it out again.
And Hartford sure does look calm after Rockford starts to attack their defensive core. They stay calm, moving the puck, and eventually do get it out.
Now they have a 2-on-1 break. They're going to slow this one up and try and make something happen. Back to the point, shot, and that one's blocked in front of the net before it got to Rask. And so now Rockford back out.
Well, Sibs, I tell you something that I'm noticing on the Rockford side is that their guys continually go for the hit at the blue line there, and it's just setting them up. It's putting them in bad position, and Hartford's getting in unscathed on odd man breaks into the zone as Rockford continues to go for the hit at the blue line with no coverage behind them. They got to settle that down a little bit and make sure that they got somebody there if they're going to go for the hit, and if not, just try and keep the play in front of them.
Rockford back into the zone, whipping it around, trying to get something going, and Blues get slammed behind the net, and now Hartford will work it out.
Beautiful hit by Greeno there. He seems to be on his game tonight. He's got two goals, and he's had several big hits.
Good opportunity there, but a nice save by Rask, keeping this at a one-goal game, and Rockford trying to work it out.
Pass another back great is, defensive play.
Yeah, nice breakup there on a pass back to the point. Rockford now takes it back. Setting up offense. Behind the net and out in front. Saved by Jones. And another beautiful leg save on the left side. And Hartford works it back out again.
Well, as good as Hartford has played in this game, Jones is a big reason why they are even in the lead right now. He's had some tremendous saves.
Both him and Rask were late season additions and guys who have shown that they belong here, playing magnificently today. We're approaching a 6.5 minute mark, still 2-1 Hartford, and now they break out, and this will be a clear break. And that might be a penalty shot. There's a trip, but it will just be a penalty.
I can't believe he didn't call the penalty shot there. He was clearly in the clear and alone on the goaltender, and I think the refs missed that one there. I think that should have been a penalty shot.
LeGamer with a slap pass, trying to get it to blind ref, who got it on net, but directly onto Rask, and he'll hold. LeGamer was clear, but just could not make it there.
Yeah, we've got 5 minutes to go here in the third period, and Rockford looks like they might be taking their time out here. Could be the Wolfpack taking their time out, but one of these teams doesn't feel like they've got enough energy to go the last 5 minutes, and I'll tell you what, this is a big 5 minutes in this series right now. We'll see if Rockford has anything that they can do to get back, get this game back to even here in the last 5 minutes of play.
We see 11 shots for Rockford, and we talked about that yesterday. You know, if they get their shot total up high, they have a good shot to win. And at this point with 5:36, 11 shots on goal, that's pretty good job by Hartford.
Well, the key for Rockford here, is they got to stay out of the penalty box, Sibs. They're taking too many penalties. This is their third penalty. They've already given up the go-ahead goal on the power play, and you know, they got to stay out of the box here to give themselves a chance to win this game.
Under five now, 40 seconds left to go in the power play for Hartford as they're trying to work it in front. And that pass is broken up, and Rockford will start out. 10 on the power play for Hartford as they were about to be even. And now all sides are even, and Rockford needs to get something going with 3.5 minutes left to go in this one. The gamer has it now for Hartford, working it in, maneuvering around. He's got two or three guys after him, still holding onto the puck. Back behind the net, shot on goal to Rask, a save, and now Rockford trying to work it out as we get close to the 2-minute mark now. And again, pass broken up time and time again. And now we're going to get a breakaway from Wally. And nice save by Rask as he tries to go backhand. And Rask is there for the attempt.
Man, Rockford needs to be a little bit more cautious with the puck here. The Wolfpack are all over everything they're trying to do and continuously getting odd man rushes, turning the puck over. They're not making any mistakes about when they're trying to poke for pucks. They've been very disciplined to this point and only taken one penalty, the Wolfpack have. And so far, they've been able to turn the puck the other direction numerous times here as Rockford needs to get something going here in the last minute so they can try and get this game tied up.
Well, Rockford's going on the power play right now, and this is a huge, huge power play, and they are one of the best teams in the league on the power play, so we'll see what happens.
Pass in front. We have another whistle, and there's going to be another penalty, and now it's a 5-on-3 for Rockford with 53.6 to go. In the faceoff now, Hartford clears it all the way down, killing time here as we get down to the 45-second mark.
That is a huge faceoff win by Wally there.
Yeah, very dangerous situation for Hartford here.
Blues trying to get in front for someone. Jones covers it. He'll hold. 35.5 left to go in this third period.
Boy, this is very dangerous for the Wolfpack. If if Hartford can win this faceoff and get a goal, you know, they're still on the power play. You never know what can happen in the final few seconds in an EA Sports hockey game.
Face off to the right of Jones. Tie up and Rockford wins it. But Hartford, again, blocking passes, disrupting the offense, and they clear it. 21 seconds left to go. Rockford trying to drive again. Point pass and a shot and a nice save by Jones, who's right there in the middle. Rockford keeps it from coming out. Blues with a attempted shot and miss. And now the Gamer's going to break out and go one-on-one with Rask, who makes a save, and there's going to be
a penalty shot there. They finally got it that time. You know, like I said before, they did miss it. You know, I thought it was a clear breakaway, and here we go.
The Gamer with the backhand, but no good. Rask is there to stop it.
Well, this has been a fun game with only 2 seconds left in a defensive zone faceoff for Rockford. It looks like Hartford's going to pull it out. But what a great game and a great defensive showing for the Hartford Wolfpack in game one.
The clock runs down, and Hartford with the 2-1 victory to give them a 1-0 lead in this series. And boy, oh boy, I tell you what. We talked about this yesterday with the guys from Hartford and, you know, Beefy and Blade, and they talked about how they wanted to play defense. And I think they may have been successful in doing that tonight.
They have a team.
Well, I think Hartford they play disciplined hockey. You know, they all know where they're supposed to be. They get a little bit out of sync from time to time, but that's to be understood. They're positionally sound. They know where they're supposed to be on the ice. They play as a team, and they got it done tonight with a relentless forecheck. They were constantly in the passing lanes, constantly in the shooting lanes, and they made life really tough on Rockford to get pucks out of their own zone and to get pucks towards their net. You know, that's a hell of a job by Hartford tonight, and I think they earned that victory in game one here.
I'll tell you what really impressed me. I was extremely impressed with Jones and net. You know, a little bit of turmoil before the game started, couldn't get his internet figured out, finally gets on 20 minutes late, you know, with the possible forfeit looming based on LG timing for scheduling a game. And he comes in there and he doesn't face a ton of shots, though it is a solid amount of shots. Made some really huge saves, especially midway through the second period there when Rockford started to pour it on just a little bit.
Well, I'll tell you what, again, heck of a game. You know, this is kind of the thing we were talking about yesterday. You know, high-scoring games have been the forte of the Rockford IceHogs. When they've been in low-scoring games, they've struggled. Their offense has struggled, and then what winds up happening is the team struggles. Both teams, 12 shots on goal, but The fact that Rockford only got 12 shots on goal, you know, you'd have to go back and look at the statistics for the season, but I can't imagine that happened too often. And that really slowed down their offense. But, man, give credit to not only the defensive players, but the front line of Hartford who came back, helped out, and knocked a lot of those opportunities away and made it awfully difficult for Rockford to get anything going.
They were relentless on their back checking. They were outstanding. They were coming back. They were driving back hard. They were getting to the puck carrier, and they were taking the puck off their stick. I mean, it was textbook back checking by Hartford. They did a great job, I thought, all the way around. You know, they played a really solid game. They didn't blow them out of the arena or anything, but they did what they needed to do to get the victory. And, you know, my hat's off to Jonesy. My hat's off to Rockford for giving it time and allowing him to get into the game. That's a class act move on their part, not calling for the, you know, for any kind of forfeits or anything. That's a class act move by Rockford. And, you know, that was a hard-fought game, but Hartford played a great game, and they deserved the victory in that one.
They sure did. We wanted to see how that defense would match up against the IceHogs offense. And though you might not say Rhino's the most potent offensive player on the IceHogs, who have a ton of potent offensive talent, I think you would say Kraz might be the one on that team. However, he was the league's leading scorer at the end of the regular season, and that Wolfpack defense was able to stifle them fairly well. You know, Rhino got on the board with the one goal, but they only gave up one total. That they stifled the IceHogs' offensive attack by playing extremely solid neutral zone defense and keeping them from breaking the plane of that blue line very many times.
Well, they were meeting them at the blue line, which is something that I love. They were meeting them at the blue line, and they were forcing them to the outside. They didn't give them much up the middle. Like I had mentioned in the game, Rockford's defense were getting caught several times looking for that big hit at the blue line when they had no help behind them. And, you know, that really led to some high-quality scoring opportunities for Hartford. And, you know, when Rockford was coming into the zone, Hartford was right there meeting them at the blue line, keeping the play in front of them, making them go to the outside, which is textbook defense, and just played a hell of a game defensively tonight and containing that high potent, that very potent Rockford offense with the league's leading scorer and his brother at center there. So that's a great job by Hartford tonight.
And we have our turns out to be our player of the game in this game one, Greeno from the Hartford Wolfpack. What a game, man. Congratulations on the two goals. Good job getting the series lead.
Oh, geez. Thanks, man. It's quite a rush. I've never been so excited over a video game in my life.
Well, you guys played a hell of a game, and your defense had every answer except for one, I guess you would say, for that Rockford offense. What was your plan heading into tonight?
Find a goalie. our plan right from the get-go on the whole season long is defense first, really, right? Everyone's got a job to do, and everyone did a great job of it, that's for sure.
Well, I don't know if everybody's plan is defense first, but I think you guys are proving that it should be. you did a really good job out there. You guys have a relentless forecheck, and you guys did really well at stepping up at the blue line. Is that something that you guys have worked on throughout the season? Is a plan for your defense is to stand them up at the blue line, or is that just something that you guys naturally played regardless?
No, you know, like I think it's faith in the forwards, you know, being a D-man on the blue line, knowing that you got guys covering your ass all the time, right? So you can take those chances and take a pinch once in a while. So it's worked out. And like you said, it's worked out for most of the season. So we're going to continue on and I'll keep playing as a team.
Well, you certainly played like a team tonight. I mean, it definitely looked like a five-man unit moving around out there, you know, kind of like a very well spread out, evenly spaced school of fish.
That's for sure.
Greeno, take us through that game-winning goal there that you had, that you scored in the, what was that, the third period there. What'd you see on that play?
Well, you know, I picked up the puck, and I'm a guy who always looks for pass first, and everything just kept seeming to open up for me. So I thought, hey, what the hell, I might as well take it in myself and try her, and things worked out. You know, like, they did a great job of covering up most of the forwards on everyone. Like I said, I was looking for the pass, but it just kept staying open, so went for it.
Yeah, and your first goal, you know, some may say was a little bit lucky, but what you did was you kept the puck from crossing out of the zone at the blue line, and you were able to get it on net, and it squeaked through to get in there. And sometimes that's all you need.
And, like, we talked about that during the intermission. Like, we had one shot, but we had the time on attack, but we only had one shot. We never got a chance to test them yet. So we said we were talking about putting pucks to the net, so we went for it, and it worked out.
I'm sure there's not a better feeling than, you know, before this game, you were just hoping, hey, we need to get this done, find a way to win, and then the game's over, and you scored two goals, including the game-winning goal in game one of the Calder Cup Finals. What's it feel like to – as a defenseman, be the scoring for your team in a Calder Cup final game? Because I'm sure your whole thought process heading into this series was just making sure you don't let the Rockford forwards get around you, and here you are doing the scoring.
Well, you know, like I said, going into it, the forwards, they did a great job of covering ourselves, so they give us D-men actually a chance. If we find room to go up through the ice, we can go, because they got us covered. So it definitely was the last thing I thought would happen in this game, but it seemed to work out.
Yeah. Well, you guys posted your lineup last night. Beefy was on here and he told us, you know, hey, we're not hiding our lineup. We've got a certain plan on what we're going to do, and I'm going to post my lineup because you're going to have to come beat us. And you guys kind of proved that tonight. What are you looking for out of the rest of the squad as you head here into games two and then three and four on Tuesday night? You got a big one tomorrow on the road again. What are you looking for out of the rest of your guys here after seeing how game one played out?
Well, I hope they watched all the streams and realized that it's going to be a grind. And now that we took the game, so all top team in the league, that anybody can do it. Now, you know, we go out there and play period by period, really. You got to take a shift. So hopefully they just keep going out there and working their hardest and sticking to our game plan.
Well, listen, man, you guys played outstanding tonight and shut down a very high caliber offense in the league's leading scorer in Rhino. Congratulations on the win. I look forward to watching the game tomorrow night to see what happens there. And good luck to the rest of you, guys on your team, the rest of this final series. And hopefully you get to lift the Calder Cup at the end of it.
Yeah, for sure, man. We got three more games to go, and hopefully we get there. But like I said, she's going to be a grind.
Well, great game tonight, man. Congratulations.
Thanks,
Thank
man.
You very much for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me. You're doing a good job. Keep it up.
All right, Greeno.
Congrats, dude.
Thank you.
Great game, buddy.
Thanks, boys.
And that, you know, was Greeno, 18-22, lefty for the Hartford Wolfpack, had two goals tonight in a 2-1 victory in game one of the Calder Cup Finals for LGAHLPSN here tonight on the broadcast. You know, he seemed pretty confident, you know. He seemed very happy with how it went.
Well, that's kind of been the story for the Wolfpack all season is, you know, they don't have the leading scorer in the league. They don't have the leading goal getter in the league. It's different guys at different times stepping up at the right time and making the plays that are needed. And, you know, at the beginning of that game, you know, you probably never would have said that, hey, their left defenseman is going to get both goals tonight, including the game winner. And, you know, they just got guys stepping up all over their lineup to make the big plays when they're needed, and that's a hell of a job by the Wolfpack.
It really is.
So the question is now, obviously Rockford is going to do what they can to make adjustments. What does Hartford do? Do they change anything? Do they anticipate that? Do they not anticipate it and just go ahead and play their game? How do you approach it if you're Hartford?
Well, you've got this is where LG comes into play. This is where we know we're not going to get the Wolfpack saw what happened tonight with the lineup they put out there, and they can just put the same lineup out tomorrow. We're going to see two totally different lineups tomorrow for game two, and we'll have to see if that line is able to replicate what this one did. I'm sure they've got the same game plan across each of their lines. But each of the three Rockford lines that they're going to face are going to be a different challenge on their own. I think that the Wolfpack have proved to this point that they're able to answer the task defensively against any team with any of their lines. But this is a different challenge when you're playing the same team in a possible seven straight games. You know, tonight it could look like one team's got it figured out, and then tomorrow night could come out and lose 6-0. You never know how it's going to go. But I will say, if Hartford can keep their defensive strategy the way that they played tonight and keep as few shots on net as possible and having a lot of those shots come from the outside, they're going to be successful by the end of this series. I can promise you that if they keep that going.
Well, we definitely saw how Greeno scored from those points. And I'm going to show the folks the first goal of the game where Rockford scored with a little more than 16 minutes left to go. He came in to the right of the circle, and that time Rass just was not up for the shot. He wound up letting it hit his pad and roll in past him, and that's what gave them the 1-0 lead. But again, we've talked about this with our teams, Mike. You know, get the damn puck on the net, and you know, sometimes that's all you need to do.
Well, it's never a bad play to put the puck on the goaltender. You know, anything can happen, especially in real life and in the video game. Anything can happen. Bounces can go any way you need them to sometimes. You know, as we all know well, they can work for you and they can work against you. And tonight it seemed like that Hartford was getting all the bounces. That first goal, you know, it was just getting the puck to the net, you know, and I'm sure, just like Greeno said, that's something that they had discussed after the first period. And, you know, they did a great job of it moving forward. You know, they got their shot totals up in periods 2 and 3, and you know, it paid off for them.
Well, and then we were able to watch Rockford come back and get their one goal of the game, as they were finally able to break the defense, getting the puck behind the net, finally getting a shot on Jones from behind, and then a big juicy rebound that Rhino was able to put home and give them the 1-1 tie at the time. And really the only moment of weakness, I think, for Jones as he stepped back a little bit from making that initial save. And that happens to every goaltender. You get on that post on the right side, and then he winds up having an issue getting back, you know, going to the left and getting back to the right. And that's kind of what happened to Jones there.
Well, and you also have guys like Rhino that do not miss those opportunities when given. So he had to play that perfectly, and he did on the initial shot. But, you know, just like any top scorer in this league, Rhino saw a little bit of daylight and was able to bury it.
And so it wasn't until the third period where Hartford was able to take the lead. And again, Greeno with a shot from a long distance from his point, and was able to get it on net. We'll show you that replay in a second. But again, talk about the importance of getting it back to your defenseman. I think again, that's what Hartford was able to do. They got it back to their guys for shots. And, you know, that's where Greeno was able to take advantage of it and put a couple of decent shots on net.
Well, what you noticed, or what I noticed when, you know, Hartford was in the zone, was they were getting their defense involved very successfully. And they weren't the only ones trying. What I noticed on the other end was that Hartford kind of had the answer to their own game plan in the offensive zone and the defensive zone, because every time Rockford fed the puck back to their defenseman, they had someone right there to knock it away and weren't able to get too much going from the top of the zone there with their two defensive guys. Hartford was all over him like a blanket. But in the offensive zone, yeah, they did a really good job of being patient down in each of the corners and holding on to the puck longer than, you know, a second or two. When they get it, they were able to hold on to it, wait for things to develop, make sure guys were open, and then get it to them. And they got some quality scoring chances and a couple of goals off of those plays.
And of course, that game winner coming right after the faceoff, starting up the third period. And Hartford brought it into the Rockford zone immediately, had a couple of chances, good passes out front. Looked like Rockford was going to get it out of the zone, but then it was actually Greeno who intercepted the pass, came in to the right circle, and then put it right past the glove of Rask, who gave up that side of the net. And boom, it was 2-1 at the 19-14 left to go mark in the third period. And that's how it ended, a 2-1 final for the Hartford Wolfpack, who now take a 1-0 lead in the series. So what do we look for tomorrow in game two?
Mike?
I think we look for more of the same from Hartford. I think they're going to continue to try and play good team defense. They do a great job on the forecheck, throwing two forwards in right up pressure in the puck with the middle guy hanging back to cut off the passing lanes and the defenders just kind of hanging back. They play a great style. I like the way they move the puck in the offensive zone. I like the way you can just see them as a formation all over the ice, whether it's on the power play, the penalty kill, forechecking, backchecking, playing defense. You know, they do it all as a team. And, you know, when you got that going for you, you're really tough to beat. Now, on Rockford's side, I think they have to get the offense going like we all know they can. I think maybe nerves might have gotten the best of them tonight. They seemed shaky coming out of the gates in the first period and just never could really get their feet under them in that game. You know, but a lot of that has to do with the relentless forecheck of the Hartford Wolfpack. But tomorrow night, I would look for Rockford to come out and really try and put the pressure on them early by getting some quick goals. But, you know, we'll see how it goes. It's going to be a battle here, and it's going to be a grind. I definitely don't expect it to be a sweep. We would all be shocked if that happened. I look for Rockford to come out tomorrow and, you know, really try and get some offense going against that Hartford defense, and we'll see who's in net for the Wolfpack.
Well, for tomorrow for the Wolfpack, Big Lammers will be in net, at least tentatively. Snick 88 will be left wing. The blind ref will be center. Boomer 879 will be right wing. Heineken's on left D and Vikes on right D. That's at this point. And based on Beef's comments last night, I suspect that that'll only change if there's any kind of availability issues that come up tomorrow afternoon. And it does look like Rask may be going in net for the Ice Hogs. That's the only position that's in for them if that stays the same. Like I said, that's tentative. But what I look to see tomorrow out of Rockford, I suspect you might get the Kraz and Shiz line tomorrow. I don't think they want to let this series get out of hand too early like they did the first two series, losing the first two games. They do not want to drop two to the Wolfpack. So I suspect you might see their number one line tomorrow night, and they may try and do what they can to break through that Wolfpack defensive pressure and see if they can get the Ice Hogs on the board here in round number two of this 7-round heavyweight fight.
Well, that just about wraps it up for us here. Again, thanks to Vihai Marinaconda. Fun doing this, right, for the first time?
Absolutely.
Yeah, it was. I hope we can only thing I would recommend to for us is to hopefully get a better schedule while we're broadcasting these games. Hopefully people are ready to go around the start of game time so we can get these things on the air for the rest of the league.
Right.
Thank you guys very much, and have a good night.
Good luck in game two.